If you're a man, you probably take pockets for granted. If you're a woman, they can make you feel like a queen. Why? Well, they store more than just our hands and possessions. If you dig deep enough, pockets also hold a fascinating history.
As a whole, I think pockets tell us a lot about the human condition.
Hannah Carlson is senior critic at Rhode Island School of Design in Providence.
The sense of, are you prepared for the world, is indicated by what you have in your pockets. So pockets become a metaphor for our thinking, for our anxieties, for our beliefs.
It's hard to imagine, Carlson says, but there was a time before pockets when women and men alike wore, well, a medieval fanny pack, until...
Pocket comes from the old Anglo-Norman word poke, which means bag, and et, the diminutive. Tailors began to put them into men's hose, which were those big pumpkin-like shaped things that Henry VIII wears. So that's the first pocket.
For men only, but women eventually get theirs.
By the 17th century, they get what are called tie-on pockets. They're pockets that are flat to the hip and which you would wear under your skirt, and you would reach your pockets through a slit so that you could access them.
Oh my gosh.
How does it feel?
It feels so roomy.
Tie-on pockets could be beautiful or utilitarian, but always downright capacious.
Definitely spectacles.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Maybe a comb.
Do you have hand sanitizer?
Pencil.
Thanks.
No.
Wrong century.
And your apple.
Ah, thank you.
Pockets could also contain secrets. There are stories of pockets being banned during the French Revolution, a time that ushered in a fashion revolution. Women began to don column-like neoclassical dresses, unwelcoming to pockets. Fashion designers thus began to sow the beginnings of more than 200 years of sartorial inequality. Pocket poverty also denied women some potent body language.
That gesture, that cool gesture, you can trace since men first get suits and can put hands in their trouser pockets.
According to Carlson, images like these were seen as scandalous in their time. Poet Walt Whitman posing defiantly. The subject of this famous Thomas Aiken's portrait, called The Thinker, was deemed vulgar for thrusting both hands into his pockets.
Your hands are right near your genitals. It was considered absolutely bad manners, and women didn't have that gesture.
Hands in pockets may have been seen as rude, but they also signaled self-possession, and early 20th century women wanted to get their hands on that. Suffragettes and flappers made pockets political.
When women get pants, that's when they really begin to explore that gesture.
Coco Chanel started creating her version of menswear with functional pockets.
A silk trouser suit with horizontal bands of contrasting color is the height of chic for evening wear.
And movie stars reveled in their trousers.
That Yves Saint Laurent image where that woman is smoking in the alleyway and she's got the cigarette and the hand in the pocket. Mm-hmm. It's like, okay, I can do it too.
But for all that swagger, women's fashion has more often left women out of pocket, which sends the same message it has for centuries, that women don't need to move as freely as men, and they don't have the same power of purchase. Recent studies depict the pocket disparity.
We've had this debate for over a century. Century and a half, we've been really upset that women don't have pockets, and it still hasn't been addressed.
Until now.
Look.
Oh my God. There's no pocket.
Meet Julie Siegel, founder of The Pocket Project.
I decided I am on a quest to deepen women's pockets.
Siegel decided to conduct an experiment of her own.
So this is a pair of women's pants. It's not even 4 inches deep.
Right.
The men's pants right next to it, it's 8 inches deep. On average, men's pockets were 3 inches deeper than women's pockets.
The inequality begins early. Check out what passes today as pants for girls and for boys. And when girls grow up, Siegel points out, this can create bias in the workplace.
Women are faced with this challenge when their work clothes don't have pockets. They can either show up with a mess of things in their hands, or they can bring a bag with them, which is this visible signal that you're a woman in the room.
Which is why every dress Siegel designs has at least 8.5-inch pockets with reinforced seams for work and life.
You know, you never know when you might want to carry a bottle of wine around with you.
And oh my gosh!
Pretty nicely.
The Pockets Project predicts progress.
Women are valuable, women have valuables, and we deserve deep pockets. We've earned them.
And so for 500 years, humble pockets have carried our secrets and desires. They've empowered us. The history of the pocket, it turns out, is more than deep. It's profound.